إن الحمد لله نحمد تعالى ونستعين ونستغفر ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فهو مهتد ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم. أما بعد، أيها الأحباب، as we see and as we encounter immense controversy, immense deception, immense confusion in the world in general, and unfortunately, specifically between the Muslims. And the Prophet alayhi afdhal salatu wassalam said, "Man ya'ish minkum ba'di, fasayara ikhtilafan kathira." The Prophet alayhi afdhal salatu wassalam said, "Whoever lives after me will see many differences." Ayol Ahbab, the many differences that we see many differences in interpretation of the Quran even. Many differences about the authenticity of the Sunnah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, or whether to take from it or not. We see many differences in controversy about who to take knowledge from. We see many controversies about how to deal with masail, major issues from the nawazil, those issues which are new issues that we face as a community, and new trials and tribulations. But the Prophet alayhi afdhal salatu wassalam, in that same hadith, he said, salawatu rabbi wa salamu alayhi, فسيرى اختلافا كثيرا فعليكم بسنتي وسنة الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين. The Prophet صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه said, "It's upon you, my sunnah, or it's an obligation upon you to follow my sunnah, and the sunnah of the rightly guided Khalifat, meaning Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, and Ali رضي الله تعالى عنهم أجمعين." So then, when questions arise and controversy comes to our communities, when people have wonder, are the Shia Muslim or not? Are the Shia our brothers or not? Is Imran Hussein, you know, his interpretation correct about the Dajjal or not? Should we engage in so Muslim or not? All of these answers, ayol ahbab, all of this controversy that people love to get involved with and engage them with can be simplified or can be dealt with in the best of manners by just returning back to what? Kitabillah wa sunnat Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even the interpretation. Why do I say this? Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, alaykum bi sunnati. It's upon you my sunnah. Go to the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and how the Khulafa al-Rashideen al-Mahdeen understood the religion. Go back to the Salaf of this Ummah. If you want interpretation for the Quran, you want the correct interpretation of the Quran. Not to say, oh brother, there's differences of opinion. Oh brother, there's a new fatwa on this. Oh brother, there's this. Sister so-and-so said this. But if we go back to what the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, when he salawatu rabbi wasalamu alayhi said, khayran nas qarni thumma alladhina yalunuhum thumma alladhina yalunuhum, the best of those of the people is my generation, then those who follow them, then those who follow them. So if we realize the immense status of the salaf of this ummah, meaning the sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in and the tabi'een رحمهم الله جميعا and the اتباع تابعين رحمهم الله جميعا, those first three generations of Islam, and we strive our best to conform to how they understood and practiced the religion, that will deal with a lot of the controversy that befalls us or that we engage in as a community. So then, if you hear someone making an interpretation about the Dajjal, saying the Dajjal is the dollar, the Dajjal is Israel, the Dajjal is this, the Dajjal is the UN, you'll be able to go back to those Nusus and say, well, we don't really have strong evidence to make those type of inferences. Those are not logical. Those are inferences based on particular individuals' logic, However, they do not have mustanid bin nusus. They don't really come from the text of the Quran and the Sunnah. So I think I will stay away from it. Or perhaps when you have confusion, well, I know many nice people who curse the Sahaba, who say Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha is an adulterer. Why can't I be friends with him? And why can't I say that they're my Muslim brothers and sisters and pray with them and pray behind them and eat with them and have social gatherings with them? Then you will be able to go back and say, well, the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in dealt with them. Even Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu ta'ala anhum burned those people who said that he was Allah. And even in that, they remained on obstinance and they said, this is further proof, or this is proof that you are Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because only Allah punishes with fire. Wa'iyadhan billah. That shows you that there is no misguidance, ashad min misguidance. After misguidance, there is no misguidance. Khalas, the person is finished. So ayyul ahbab, strive your best to go back to those sources, to learn those sources. And if you take knowledge from individuals, then make sure that they're coming from those sources. Then you have safety in your religion. Otherwise, you'll be confused and you'll go to the left and you'll go to the right every time a new issue comes up, every time a new controversy comes up, every time a new situation arises, and you'll have no basira, you'll have no insight, you'll have no hikmah, you'll have no wisdom to fall back on, and you'll have no fiqh. You'll have no understanding and how to deal with those issues. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by all his names and attributes, to give us fiqh fi deen. Rabbana atina fi dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina adhab an-nar. Allahumma as'alaka ilman nafi'an rizqan tayyiban wa 'amalan mutaqabbilan. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.